I'm here with one of the most talented young fighters in the world, Leo Santa Cruz. First of all, how you been, Leo? How's life treating you?
I'm good. I mean, yeah, life's been treating me good, thank God. And I've been training hard, ready, and I'm here.
It seems that you're active and more than many other fighters these days.
Yeah.
You fight, and 2 minutes later, you're fighting again.
Yeah, that's what I like to do. Like, I like fighting, so thank my manager, and thank Golden Boy that they keep me busy and for the fans to keep me in touch and that. So they could notice me more and I could get more fans.
Leo, you always have tough fights. Tell me about this fight this weekend, Saturday at Staples Center.
Yeah, it's gonna be a tough fight. He's a Mexican. You're Mexican, they come forward, they throw a lot of punches and they don't give up. And they
sound
that,
like you.
Yeah, they say he's a forward fighter. I don't really know much about him, but I seen a video of him and he comes forward. So, and he has good uppercuts. He has good punches. So it's gonna be a hard fight, but we train really hard. We're ready for everything.
What do you think about Mars Moreno?
Oh, I think that's gonna be a really good fight too. It's gonna be a tough fight, but I think Moreno, I think Mighty will take it.
What do you think about Pedro Angulo?
Oh, he's like a good fighter too. He has power, he comes forward like a Mexican too. He comes forward throwing punches, he never stops, and really strong.
Leo, why do you love boxing so much? What is it about this sport?
Oh, I don't know, maybe since I was small, like since I was always going to the gym with my brothers, I saw them and maybe since that day I started loving boxing. And when I first put my gloves for the first time and I got in the ring, I didn't know nothing. My dad told me, you want to get in the ring sparring? I was like, yeah. And then since that day on, I liked it. And they told me, oh, you're really good. Because I sparred with this kid that he had like already a few months. And I think I beat him.
Yeah. You remind me a lot of Margarito. Do you get that a lot?
Yeah, I do. I get that a lot. I'm like the second Margarito. And yeah, it's a good thing that they compare me because Mario's really good. He throws a lot of punches. The only thing he was is his defense, but I think I have good defense, and for people to compare me to him is like an honor.
You're one of the fighters that people pay money to watch because you always put on a show. What's it like to be in there and exchange and get punch and punch? And
well, it's exciting. It's exciting because right there, you see that that's what people want in boxing. And if you make the people happy, it makes you happy because you get more fans, and that's what but the people love. And for me to see that people's reaction and everything, it makes me happy.
You're an exciting fighter. If you could list the five most exciting boxers in the world today, according to Leo Santa Cruz, who do you go with?
Well, I think it's Pacquiao, Cotto, Mayweather, and
Sergio.
Yeah, Sergio. Yeah, Martinez. Yeah.
Canelo.
Yeah, Canelo too. Yeah, there's a lot more, but
right. But some just like bring it.
Yeah.
Like, would you ever want to fight Nonito?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, him too. I was gonna say I would like to fight him because he's one of the best in my weight. Cause I'm gonna move probably 122, and I want to go after him, and I want to be the best, and he's the best right now. So if I beat him, that would put me on top, and I would like that fight, but probably a few more, like one or two more fights, so I could get him with him.
Elliot, what does this success mean to you, to your family, to your neighborhood? How do people treat you now versus a year ago?
Oh, way different.
Why?
It means success because maybe more people recognize me now than since I'm champion now. They notice me more and everything, because before, not that much people knew me. And then since I've been fighting in Showtime, it's like that's worldwide. A lot of people get to see me, so now they notice me. I'm on the streets, they call me, oh yeah, you're Leo Santa Cruz. I'm like, yeah, and then, so way, way different.
But you haven't changed. Some people get a little success and they go Hollywood, and you're the same Leo you were 2 years ago and 10 years ago.
Yeah,
why not? Why didn't you just, like, hey, you're a champion now.
Yeah,
you can have the bling and the belt. And
no, I think everything, I'm always thinking that the money and the thing and the success is not supposed to change you. You're supposed to be how the people met you. That's how you always have to be, and that's my mentality. That always be the same. There's nothing different. I'm still the same. I still speak to people the same. Everything I see the people, and I'm just gonna be the same always.
My last question: when you were a kid, who's the one fighter you looked up to the most?
That's true. I had two. Oh. It was Oscar Loya and Julio César Chávez.
And now you're fighting for Oscar, and I bet you can knock Chávez Senior out.
Yeah. Yeah, probably. I could now. He's old already, so yeah.
Why not? Are there any message to your fans that they're watching?
Oh yeah, I just want to tell them that this fight I dedicated to my fans. I trained hard for them and to give them a good show, and come support me on November 10th, and I'm going to try my best to give them a good show.
There you have it, world champion Leo Santa Cruz, one of the most exciting fighters in the world today. For EastEastReport.com, I'm Ali Segback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Segback.